Sky's Gulf correspondent Nashis Joshi is in the Iranian capital, where he witnessed today's protests.
The signs were there, and so was the warning. Public protests would not be tolerated. Around Tehran, pro-reform protesters have taken to the streets in defiance. Hours after the result was announced, before all the votes had been counted, demonstrators gathered in Fatemi Square. This is just a few hundred meters away from the Interior Ministry where the votes were collected.
Weeks after a fruit vendor committed suicide to protest low wages and corruption, demonstrators took to the streets of the capital, Tunis. They came by the thousands, marching on this tree-lined street to tell their president of 23 years, Zine El Abidine Ben Ali, that they'd had enough. Enough unemployment, poverty, and control.
I want freedom. Freedom. Only freedom. Freedom.
Thank you. Very clear to the Assad regime, but also to other players on the ground, that a red line for us is we start seeing a whole bunch of chemical weapons moving around or being utilized.
This morning, Syrian rebels tell us there was a series of what they claim were chemical weapons attacks. 10 villages at least to the east and north of Damascus, hit by what rebels say were surface-to-surface missiles fired by the regime and tipped with chemical weapons. The death toll, well over 1,000. Symptoms before death, witnesses tell us, were shortness of breath, constricted pupils, foaming at the mouth. We've seen videos posted online showing many women and children among the dead.
But this still photo captures a sliver of the horror. Syrian citizens trying to identify the dead bodies of children in the town of Arbin in Damascus. You've blurred the faces in this picture. More amateur video captures smoke rising in the aftermath of the bombings. Meanwhile, the stance of the major powers in regard to this conflict seems largely unchanged.